Well, what's up, you guys? It's Sir Scrub here, bringing you some more Scrub Tier Yu-Gi-Oh! And in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at my long-awaited World Chalice deck profile for the April 2020 format. But before we get into today's video, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe, and let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. And if you do want to see more creative videos from me, please be sure to check out the description with all the different ways you can support the channel. And make sure you check out the Coalition of Scrubs linked in my description box as well, where I have partnered with several other fantastic content creators to make a community platform. So be sure you check that out. Check out all the guys that are over there. They're all fantastic. They all deserve it. But with all that junk out of the way, let's go ahead and jump both feet into today's video. Starting off with our World Chalice engine with three copies of World Chalice Guard Dragon. Firstly, he is adorable. So I just want to get that out of the way. I think this card is absolutely just adorable. Beyond that, he is a hand trap. He's an extender. He's a dragon monster. He's fantastic. You don't necessarily need three. You could cut it to one, to two, because you only need two for your combo. But I like having three just in case you draw it. It gives you another extender, because you do use a World Chalice Link monster to start your play, so you could summon it from your hand, and you can also use it to protect your linked monsters from targeting. Then we have three copies of Lee, the World Chalice Fairy. This is pretty standard as well. Lee's a fantastic monster. She's necessary for the Lee Transmod combo. But not only that, she's another World Chalice name. She gives you a search, so she allows you to tutor for the things that you're missing when you have to go into her, so that's that. Then we have two copies of World Legacy World Chalice, probably the best card in the entire deck. This card just gives you advantage just for the crime of playing Yu-Gi-Oh! So it's really good, it's really necessary. It just basically allows you to make your plays, pretty much. And then the enabler for World Legacy, World Chalice, is going to be the Venus and Shine Ball engine. Here, let me scoot this up so we can see it all. We're playing three Venus and only two Shine Ball. Now, you only need two Shine Ball in this deck because two is the only thing that's necessary for you to get your combo play started. The third one is a little bit of just extra gas in your tank, which I have found in playtesting my combos, you really don't need the third one, because if everything's going like it's supposed to, you should have more than enough extenders. Beyond that, we are also playing Pot of Avarice in this deck, so we do have the capability to recycle the Shine Balls. That's it for your main engine. The rest of the monster lineup is mostly supporting engines. Starting off with three copies of Psychic Wielder. This is our Needle Fiber target. Anytime we have this monster in any level 3 on board, we can just vomit this from our hand onto the board to immediately be able to go into Needle Fiber. And of course, our Needle Fiber target is going to be Mecha Phantom Beast O'Lion. Then to help out with our combo plays, I'm also playing three copies of Crusadia Draco, just as a good dragon extender to help make the Guard Dragon package a little bit more consistent. And then of course the one copy of Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon. Then for hand traps, the only hand trap in the deck, because we're really, really tight on space, is three copies of Effect Veiler. This is one of the best all-around generic hand traps. You could play Nibiru, you could play Impermanence, you could play Ash. This is just your hand trap slot. And then our final monster is going to be the one copy of Gamma Seal, because we are playing the Kaiju package, because it's just so free, it's so good. You summon this thing off of Saryuja, and you've basically got a ridiculous amount of negates, and it gives your whole board protection from Kaiju, so there's also that. For the rest of the spells, we start off with two Avarice. Really fantastic card. This card is basically just Pot of Greed in this deck, but even better because it allows us to recycle our Shine Balls, so that's really cool. We have two copies of Upstart Goblin in the form of Draw Muscle. We have so many low stat monsters that we summon frequently. You just summon them in defense points in this, in defense mode, and this gives you a free draw. For our playmakers, we have the two copies of Transmodify. I cut this down to two, because while you do want to open it, if you open the Lee Transmodify, with any other hand, this card is dead. And I really wish that I could find some way to break this deck's reliance on the Venus Chalice combo. But until I can find that way, this is necessary. It's really just necessary to have a backup plan. And then for more extenders, we have two copies of World Legacy Guard Dragon. I really, really like this card. I think this card is fantastic. It's a monster reborn. It allows you to play around with your columns. So maybe if you started your combos off expecting to go into one line of play, but found out that you couldn't quite make it, you made a misplay, this allows you to recover by moving your pieces around. Then we have the one copy of World Legacy Succession. This is to be set off of Lib, so that's why we only play one. And then to round out the main deck, we have two copies of Call by the Grave, because we don't like hand traps, but you really don't want to reduce the consistency of your combo pieces for the sake of protecting yourself from them. That's it for the main deck. Should be an even 40 cards. Moving into the extra deck. Starting off with the Link 4, as we have one copy of Saryuja Skulldrib and one copy of Borlo Dragon. You make this go in first, you make this go in second. It's not really that hard. You can also make the Borlo Dragon in the middle of your combos to help make your board better, because we are utilizing Trigate Wizard to be able to use negations, so Borlo's side arrows come real, real handy. Then we have one copy of Unicorn and one copy of Phoenix, just for a little bit of removal, a little bit of disruption, stuff like that. Then for our big Link 2s, we're playing a whole host of them. We're playing, of course, Mascarena, Lib, and Needle Fiber. So these are the three main cards that have really taken this deck to a completely different level. You could play Union Carrier, but I didn't want to add any extra bricks in here. So that's why it's just these three. These three allow you to do so much. Because you can summon the Mascarena, say, above the Trigate Wizard like this, and then link off into the Unicorn to still be able to lock it and get an extra disruption from the cards. So they're really, really great. They really take, these three cards really, really just take the ceiling of this deck to a whole nother level, just allowing you to wombo combo all over the place. Then we actually play a pretty extensive list of Link 1s. We have, the Guard Dragon package, one LP, one Pisty. Then we're playing the one copy of Imduck, which is really necessary to kickstart our plays. One copy of Almirage, which helps you to unbrick your hands. And one copy of Relinquished Anima to help you with our... We do have some level 1 monsters that sometimes you really just need to make a Link monster. But it's also really good for just removing threats and stuff like that if your opponent's careless. So yeah. That's it for the Link monsters. The last two monsters in the extra deck are your Needle Fiber targets. So we have the Desert Locust to rip a card out of our opponent's hand, and then the Draco Berserker of the Tenyi to be able to get another form of disruption off of it. But that's all I've got for this video, you guys. If you did enjoy this video, please be sure to leave a like and subscribe, and let me know your thoughts down in the comment section below. And if you do want to see more creative videos from me, please be sure to check out the link in the description with all the different ways that you can support the channel. Also, be sure to check out the Coalition of Scrubs and give us a subscribe over there. Check out all my buddies that work with me over there. But most importantly, don't forget, be a scrub.